weapon, 492 Dream Team, but there was just too much firepower from Team One as they claimed victory over 92 Dream Team, 7-3.
Meanwhile, earlier on in the day, they were also able to take a win on the same map against Dark Zero, 7-4. Disrupt Gaming also would fall to them on this map, 7-5. There's that IQ ban again.
Yeah, so I'm very interested as to why they banned the IQ. I would have to say it's because of Pulse or something along those lines, but that wasn't even one of their most played defensive operators. Actually, this might be it. It's the Valkyrie cameras. Reduck does a lot with those Valkyrie cameras on defense. We saw that yesterday. A lot of his plays were calculated off of the information from those black eye cams. So they're getting rid of IQ because obviously she counters that directly. So they ban Echo just because they don't like to play against him, not because they wanted to use him banning IQ. They ban IQ to take away from the potential to get rid of that black eye utility.
Well, we're going to see Mira being the other defender ban, so they won't attempt to try and ban out the Valkyrie in order to get a counter on that. And as a result, they'll have that little bit of extra fire, or that have that little bit of extra intel. It should be noted, of course, that Secret can use it just as well if they want to play into Valkyrie play. Well, here we go, into round number one. It's going to be the players from Secret on defense to start things off. Same place where they ended on our last map. And their opponents, Team One, will be on the attack. Attack, of course, a little bit weak for both of our teams back on Villa. But if we judge it from yesterday's matches, this was the side where Team One was to be feared. So we'll have to see if things remain the same or if Secret's going to be able to put up a little bit better of a defense than we saw from some of our other teams yesterday. And they are able to stem the tide against these very aggressive and very powerful rushes and fast-paced plays that we were seeing from Team One on this map.
For all of you folks at home that weren't tuned in for our last game yesterday between Team One and 92 Dream Team, I want you guys to pay attention to Lucid and how he plays with Skadina. Skadina is their entry fragger. The difference between entry fragger and secondary entry is the entry fragger is the one who takes the brunt of the gunfight. That secondary fragger is a man that is there for the refrag. Team One, again, this is what they talked about yesterday after their interview on this exact map. We are nuts at refrag. And that's what I want to see if Team One is supposed to walk away with this map.
Well, let's see if they're gonna be able to do it. Into the round we will go, and of course, as you generally expect, we're gonna start on Hookah Billiards. This will be the go-to site for most teams nowadays, and like I said as well, preferences kind of tend to shift every once in a while, but this is the play, this is the site to play into right now. We're gonna see that Castle Barricade go up on the big window. Assumably will be dealt with relatively quickly by the Team One roster, but let's stem the tide for a few seconds and give Secret a few extra moments of clarity.
It's going to be a pretty standard hold here from Team Secret, reinforcing the usual things. Got some reinforcements on the VIP wall, so you can't hold the cross angle, things along those lines. But we do have Pharah on Pulse. That's actually going to be a really big play by Team Secret, because there's no IQ in play. So Pulse has free reign to really do whatever he wants, unless Team One adopts a Jackal, a Dokubi, something to try and make this man move out of his fortress downstairs.
Which at this point they don't really have. There's a Twitch that could try to spot things, but at the same time that same exact job could be done by anyone with a drone. It's really special in that respect. Little Kid making a crazy run out. Skadina apparently involved in this as well. Or excuse me, it's Leon that makes the run out, and unfortunately he's not going to come out with a victory on that at all. Skadina is able to counter it very quickly. And off of that, we'll see Team Secret fall. A 5v4 now set against them with the loss of Leo. Leon.
Alem's trying to be smart and recognizes out that they use Twitch quite a bit on this map. That was Skadina's most played operator yesterday when they did play against 92 Dream Team. It sees that that trend is going to continue. But Alem's trying to be smart, stay on his evil eyes to get rid of these Twitch drones so they wouldn't destroy his evil eyes. But that's not going to be the case. He tries to open up the slider and he will get punished for that. Is Pharah doing his damnedest downstairs to try and find somebody with this nitro cell? Is it going to confirm? No, it's not. That's not going to find him. Timing, timing, timing is the game of Rainbow Six Siege. And Team One is going to skip past with kind of an explosive ending.
See, Fonker is going to be holding the line at the billiards bar right now. He's got a pressure coming his direction from at least two different spots right now. He's got VIP presence along with players. Still trying to push into him from the aquarium. Skadina, a nice hold, is able to actually find Fonkers getting pretty aggressive, trying to push back out into the open. Unfortunately, he's not given much of a choice though because of that. And that's another kill, basically sniped out by Team One. Secret now going to be put into a very delicate position. Only three players left standing. Some of them still off site too. And the Team One may be able to go for a relatively quick execute here. They still have to try and bait out some of the smoke, toxic waves that he can throw in here in order to delay this push. 50 seconds left. They're still going to be able to waste that time away. Probably have a few extra seconds to go for the plant. Pressure coming through the wall against him. It's actually a miracle that Meepy's still alive right now. He's going to have to be very careful about how he proceeds from this point forward.
Team One so very good about pinching this site? Limbs going to find Falls as Falls will stand up, but Meepy's now down, and that's going to be a big deal. Feral was downstairs, but not going to be too effective without that Nitro Cell, so he's going to try and rotate up, and he's going to find Luke. And Team One, again, they're very good at pinching this site, and traditionally how they do it is they take Aquarium, try and hold those cross angles, then push their operators up past VIP. Getting aggressive on that wall, but Alim, speaking of aggression, will find yet another. Feral going to continue to tack on. It's all up to Skadina. He finds one. Feral's going to try and tuck in. Only 5 seconds. Going to have to get aggressive, but his leg's going to hang out. Skadina only had 5 kills in the entire map yesterday. He's already got 4 right now.
Great stuff from Skadina. That was what you talked about, was the 1vx capability. Despite having relatively low stats overall, still ended up with the most 1vxs on the team, looking at that match from yesterday against 92 Dream Team. And as a result of that, that's what we talked about coming to this match, that clutch factor from Skadina that couldn't be discounted. And we see it come into play right there. A crucial mistake made by the last player from Team Secret in assuming that the legs wouldn't be sticking out. And that just gives away the kill. Over to the Twitch, Skadina. And of course, the round to Team One.
It's times like that where you try and make the smart play, but even in that instance, I believed in Feral on winning that gunfight if he would have taken it. But granted, you are going up against the F2, the best assault rifle in the game. It's no argument. That gun, its damage margin as well as the rate of fire and practically no recoil. I mean, what else could you want from a weapon? Feral rocking the UMP 45, which is a good weapon, but slow the rate of fire. If he did not hit that man in the head, he's more than likely going to lose that gunfight. So you can see it from both ends of the spectrum, but as of right now, Team One going to be in the lead after a little bit of a dicey round there last time, but nonetheless, they will claim that first round.
It's on the attack as well, meaning the defenders are more than likely going to shift right back over to Hook and Billiards, which indeed they have done. So we're right back on that same site. It's still very close for Secret. Obviously, they got a little bit aggressive in the beginning, too. Leon trying to make that run out happen that didn't really end up playing well into his favor. And, of course, on top of that, a few other potentially avoidable deaths, too, happening with Team Secret. So they'll probably tighten that up relatively quickly. Look to play, I would assume, a little bit more passively this time against Team One, as they were just slowly creeping around and doing a great job at anti-roam. And as a result of that, we'll end up with Team One having to see one of those kind of trademark crazy executes we were seeing a lot of yesterday against 92 Dream Team.
As we were talking about with Villa, yesterday Team One was making some very aggressive plays with their early drone presence. They would pre-place drones on a lot of portions of the map, which is a routine thing inside of competitive. But the main thing is, a lot of their drone presence they would place on one area of the map and just take it with full force immediately, whether it was one person inside of that room or none. Just forcibly grab that site. They did that quite often yesterday with Hookah, and we'll see. It looks like they're actually getting prepped for it once again. They do have the lifeline out. If he impacts low enough on the door, it will get rid of that barbed wire. Then Meepy's going to be in between a rock and a hard place. He's going to be leaning on his co-anchor, Alims, to try and put in some work with that Alda.
Fonker's still trying to work around here, trying to see if he can scout out the push happening a little bit earlier, but that's not where it's going to be coming from. It's down on the Hookah balcony where most of the pressure they're attempting to throw in is coming from right now. Lucan getting the spot onto the player, hiding out behind the Hookah bar itself. But a few players going to try to play into the window here too, it looks like, on the attack. One of them going to go in, try to go for the stun. Meepy still holding on pretty strong, though. Picks up one frag against Ryze. The problem is he cannot stand up from that one single position. If he does, he's a dead man. He's relying on support coming in from Billiards instead. But mind you, they could pretty easily apply pressure to the other side or just peek the window. That'll work, too. Falls picks up the frag against Fonkers. Leon, though, able to catch the trade and actually makes it work with the aggressive play this time around. Great stuff from Leon. He does fall, but it's a 1-for-2 trade on a runout. Still take that win every single day. Feral adds on to the kill counter here for Team Secret as it's left all down to Lucid in a 1v3. You can already hear that Nitro Cell. He can't run in through this door.
This all opened up on the fact of Falls with the Thermite actually taking the aggressive angle, going upside down like Spider-Man and giving that Spider-Man kiss over to Fonkers as the Jaeger. Leon, though, hopping out the window, going to make that aggressive play as Blue stated and completely flipping this round on its head. It's all left up to Luca, but he's now down. Feral's going to claim the life from upstairs, but should have been Maestro's kill, but doesn't matter. It's a team game. It's a team game. We don't count till stealing here.
So still kept the aggression in play for Secret. Like I said, I was assuming they were going to try to pull it back a little bit and play a lot more passively on the site, which could have had the potential to play pretty poorly considering the kind of headstrong mentality that we saw the members of Team One try to take into this round by trying to force the issue in through Hookah. But thankfully, they did bring the aggression, just at a much better time this time around, with Leon attempting to boot that balcony run out later on in the round when he was able to find the easy double kill in order to solidify the win for his team.
Interested to see if Team Secret tries to keep up the same pace on defense. Granted, they're not trying to do it with everybody now, because that's really what was going on with Villa. They just were getting so aggressive from every angle. And then when they got man advantage, they'd slow things down, rotate people back to site, and just play turtle. Try and keep everyone inside, make Team 1 come hunting for them, which is a very smart thing to do. You see that quite often throughout the competitive scene of Rainbow Six Siege. You get those early picks, might as well rotate back to site and force them to try and dig you out of a hole. But this time around, Team Secret going to be one taking the initiative. And Leon's actually going to claim 2 lives off of that, which I think that was the most impressive thing for me, is he actually killed someone down lower that was underneath the Sunrise balcony as well. So, very, very interesting stuff coming out from Team Secret.
Secret, of course, now looking to build on their first win with another play towards Kitchen. This is where we saw one of the crazier plays from Team 1 yesterday, as they had a pretty aggressive strategy to work their way in, especially after getting an early pick onto the bathroom player right next to service entry. They were able to just push right in through service and force the issue. Nearly won the round on that more than one occasion. So we'll see if they try to bring it back this time. First of all, if the defensive lineup from Team Secret even allows Team 1 to try and go for something like that. So it looks like Secret are still spread out pretty thin right now. They do have quite a bit of presence upstairs, of course, to defend the VIP still from the assault on Team 1. And it looks like keep a few people over by the bars as well, as they're expecting some pressure from the pool side.
Team 1 still very aware of how Team Secret is trying to roam, so that's why they are going to adopt the Nomad for the second time here, is those air jabs will definitely make it a lot easier on them. You don't have to have a jack, but you can set up 3 of those across the map. Listen for that massive air burst, and then you know that something definitely happened over that quarter of the map. Oh my god, no way.
They're doing it again, look.
Go to Reduct, please. How did this even happen? Did they just smoke off everything and run for it? They did.
Yup, pretty much exactly. And a crazy fight's going to transpire out of it. It brings us down to a 2v1. Secret recover from this, actually. Now have the man advantage. And again, it's on Lucan. Look at how low he is as well. He goes down to Feral Secret. What a recovery. After getting the surprise plant sprung on them once again, they bring it back. They close out the round. And now they take the lead 2-1.
Fucking easy.
I love these guys, man.
I don't know if you guys heard that, but I hope you did.
I hope you did, because it would just make it so much better. Because then, otherwise, we just laughed for no reason. Everyone's going to be like, Blue and Stokes are actually insane. But, my God, man. Team 1 tried it yesterday against 92 Dream Team. It worked out pretty well the first time they did it. They tried it again, which it got thwarted. But for Team Secret, I don't even really know how to describe that. You can say it's refrags, but it was more or less, we have to kill everyone right now. Otherwise, they're going to be able to set up angles and hold this diffuser.
They might have just watched some of the VODs from
and knew it was going to happen.
Like, saw, like, yeah, they might try this on. Especially when you consider, right, they played pretty light on service. They didn't have anyone there originally taking. It almost seems like they were kind of playing
baiting
for
it.
A retake.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, come on in. It's wide open.
Yeah, like,
and
come
then
here,
we're
going to
go back and
retake.
Yeah. It almost seemed like they tried to play into that. And if that was the case, I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah, I think Helby's got a good noggin on him. I think that might be something they pull out of their pocket. It's always a good bait and switch if you see stuff like that. Again, Rainbow Six is a very big mind game in that kind of instance. It's, you know, we're going to let you think that you have this. You know, we're going to let you think that we're not prepared. And flip the coin on him, or flip the script. But Team Secret, the thing I'm very interested on is, did Team 1 dedicate anything, Claymore, anything to the double window upstairs for Penthouse? Or did somebody hop out of it? I don't think I saw, in that blur of kills and just aggression from every single angle, I don't think I saw enemy detected outside through that. So I think that a lot of it was just Lamborghini doorway, that main lobby area, and inside of the bathroom as well, as I believe we had someone holding the kitchen window that also perished.
Yeah.
So, quick setup by Team 1, but again, that is going to falter later on as Team Secret battles back.
So, 2 successful defensive rounds in a row for Secret. They're going to continue to roll around their sights, and that's a very aggressive play from Feral.
Okay.
Stands right up on top of the check-in desk, and Ryze will take that all day long.
Well, if you're going to send it, then send it. And that's exactly what Feral tried to do, and did not end up working out for him. Team 1, last time that they had man advantage, did not work out for them too well either. So We'll see if they able to find a round after finding this initial kill under Feral. That's one less roamer they have to worry about. But as we've seen, Leon doesn't care if he has an M45. He will hop out of every window, take every gunfight. It doesn't matter if it's Twitch, Ash, Zofia, Capitao. It doesn't matter what is on the other end of the spectrum. He has the weapon of choice that he wants, and he's going to try and take that firefight to you.
Well, of course, with Castle remaining a pretty constant mainstay for Secret whenever it can be applied, Zofia is going to be the same thing for Team One to be able to deal with this. They've already pushed through Kitchen relatively quickly, have the setup. Another member of Secret just getting caught this time. It's Redux picking up the kill against Fonkers this time. And this is an easy 5v3 that Team One's been able to acquire in the early round.
We have a man inside of the kitchen for Team One right now. The rest of the team is more or less focused on office, so they are trying to pinch down on a site again and just isolate these players. They know that Smoke is the only man on site. I guarantee you that they have a drone in here somewhere recognizing out that Meepy will be the only one. You can see how they're more or less prone. You see a drone rotating in right now, so they are going to get that information. They do actually have a limbs downstairs very close to that connected hallway that's attached to Sunrise. So Ryze is going to be on the hunt upstairs for any possible roamers. There is going to be one man upstairs. It's going to be Leon as he's trying to bide his time upstairs in Aquarium, but I believe that Ryze knows about him. Leon definitely knows about him, especially after that gunshot. They're actually going to have Lucan move upstairs, and look at that pinch set up so cleanly by Team One. Put somebody on rappel on the Aquarium balcony, have somebody push up luggage, get that easy kill. It's only left up to the two men on site, and it's a wrap. It is a wrap for Team One here. Some beautiful plays coming out, taking their time, using that drone to try and find as many players as possible, recognize out that Leon was missing from the equation on site. We better go find him.
Convincing closeout to be sure for Team One. Now it's going to be how they try to build onto this and try to pull it off in a full 5v5, because that was their struggle leading up to this point. And ultimately, the mistakes made by Team Secret are very easily correctable over the course of that round. They should be able to rebound from that. Not only that, but of course they're getting more of their own sites they prefer to play on unlocked again. So Secret are not necessarily in trouble after that round loss either. But it does, of course, take us into another tied situation where the teams are deadlocked.
Not the new stuff. Not the new stuff, okay? Let's do the other stuff.
Yeah. Let's do the other stuff. We're doing the other stuff, boys. That's what we're doing. So.
Yeah, I'm doing two Shaco with Feral, I think.
I'm going to talking points there as we hear from the teams. But I will say one thing, though. I like a team that can do it all. You know, I like a team that can be hyper aggressive, and it's like with a scalpel, just surgical, you know, where it's all controlled. They know exactly what they want. It isn't just wide sprung and just throwing whatever you can on the wall and hoping that it sticks. Team One's good at that, but they're also good at trying to set up this offense for a late round aggression. I mean, the post drones is really what I'm talking about here. They get what they want. They get control of office. They get a couple of these roamers killed, and they go, okay, we want somebody in kitchen, but our main focal point is going to be over here inside of offices. Let's get a drone inside. Let's see how many people are on site. Let's get another site count. We want to know how many people are on site. Okay, we have two. We know that. We know Smoke and Maestro are both on site, but Leon's missing. Where is Leon? Where could he possibly be? Well, they had that hatch that was open, so he's more than likely going to be inside of couches, billiards, or aquarium. He's going to be roaming around there, or at least rotating that distance. We're actually going to have, I believe, a spawn kill come out?
It's going to window key from Fonkers.
All right, well, Fonkers is going to end up downing the Capitao, but I guess we get to talk about life mechanics now for just a second. This has been changed up. Not very recently, but it's still recent enough to be a talking point. As you guys can see, Reduct only has 20 HP currently. It got changed from 50 about 3 months ago. So it used to be that you could down yourself, pick yourself back up, you're below 50 HP. But now, resets really aren't a thing, because 20 HP is still relatively just one bullet from any weapon in this game.
So resets are dead, folks.
Resets are dead.
Basically,
crab.
The moral of the story.
Resets are dead. Crab.
You might see a very rare one every once in a while, but it's, yeah. I personally haven't seen one since the change. So let's get back into it here. Team Secret, obviously a surprising start for them to be able to find Reduct like that. It's been unfortunate they weren't able to confirm the kill, but I think the Jaeger did not want to try and attempt that for a second time. You can see Fonkers did take damage from the play. Got Luka with the drone play as well, able to find some intel early on. Now, this could get interesting. There you go.
Very nice kill by Lucan, but very smart of him. He called for help by his teammates, as you can see T1 rotating up the main stairs. So instead of making the aggressive play and trying to get that kill for himself, play smart, holds both doors on that angle, forces Jaeger to either rotate out or rotate towards him, making that gunfight a lot easier for Lucan.
Lucan, as such, closes out, is able to trade this back now after Skadina has also been lost. But you have to remember, of course, the Capitao there. the top left of Team One's UI has also been brought down incredibly low. That was the player who was down earlier, but they revived back up. But with 20 HP, as you were mentioning, he can only take one shot from anyone. And he's a crucial piece of their utility. They can't really afford to lose him at this point in the game. So they have to be very careful with how they proceed with him.
This roam game still in effect for Team Secret, even though they are down one member of the team. But Funkers definitely did his due diligence, as you guys can see once again, Redux health down to 20 HP. And hopefully he doesn't eat one of his own asphyxiating bullets here in case somebody walks in front of him. But it appears that Team One isn't ready just yet. They're definitely not ready now, as Leon is going to find Falls from underneath with that Nitro Cell. And that's going to be the Valkyrie, not the Pole. So playing off of those Black Eye cans, doing his damnedest, as Redux is going to take quite a bit of damage. He's definitely down to that one-shot range right now. He's going to get aggressive still. Doesn't even matter on the health line. Lucid can attack on. It's a 2v2 with only 20 seconds left. Very minimal health once again on this Capitao, but this Diffuse Plant will go through here in the last couple of seconds. It's all on Leon and Feral. And who better to do it, ladies and gents? Feral yesterday, 16 kills for him on Border against Nip. Continuing here today with his fantastic play on defense.
What a crazy read from Redux we had there, though. Ended up hopping over the wall inside of Huga, just either having the intel or at least having an intuition that his opponent wasn't going to be expecting that. I certainly would have, at a minimum. And the crazy play, despite him being basically one-shottable, nets him another kill and a chance for his team to close out, but still, very easy retake with both those players being at low HP at the end of the round for Secret. Surgical 2v2, and they still bring it back and end up 3-2 overall on the map now.
I mean, even with that, if you really want to get deep in an analysis right here, look at how Team Secret sets that up at that 2v2 point. They have one person holding the door for Rotate as well as Cool Boy upstairs. You have the other gentleman inside of Billiards taking the angle, forcing someone to rotate over into the opposite angle. That's surgical.
Absolutely. Some surgical stuff from Secret to bring it back. And this is after they lost a good amount of their roaming presence in the early round, too, with what ended up happening over towards Penthouse. So it's good that they're still able to establish that presence in the late round and make something like that happen with their players being as split up as they were towards that point in the round. So Secret shoots ahead again. We're back over towards Kitchen. Last round, last time we played on this site is where Team One assumably got baited into a plant, and Secret was able to punish that pretty heavily to quickly defuse it.
I will say, I'm still very happy with Team One's play overall. I mean, again, you're playing against the number one seeded team, and again, if you guys, anybody is a March Madness fan, this does not happen very often when the bottom seed, the number 16, the number 8, what have you, puts up this good of a fight against the top team at the tournament. Team Secret, again, top team right now, the 3-0. Team One, 3-2. And I think the biggest thing for me on that is the two maps that they lost were Villa and Bank in that playthrough. They lost to Rogue 7-2, and they lost to Vitality 7-4. So Rogue was the Villa map, Vitality was the Bank map. So that's why I was very interested to see them allow Villa through, because it appeared that they really didn't have anything set up, but a lot closer game for Team Secret.
Feral's going to start us off strong here again for Team Secret, as he is able to find the Nomad early on. Feral's going to be happy about who specifically he knocked down as a result of that. Unfortunately, he's quite low now, so he's probably not going to find himself in too much of an aggressive situation throughout the rest of the round. I would expect him to fall back and start to set up the Goo Mine Matrix.
So you are going to see Meepy opening the VIP floor to look down at now a pretty routinely planted spot inside a kitchen. You can actually hop up on that counter and you can still plant, and keeps you pretty safe from anybody sitting inside of delivery or that little pantry room over on the other end of the kitchen. So Team Secret gonna continue their set in ways where they get that initial pick or that initial damage and then allow Team One to try and come hunting. But Team Secret is not just prey. They are definitely predator as well. They are just lying in wait. Their next victim here is Lucid. It's appearing that he wants to set up a couple of angles at a bathroom. Gonna use a concussion to make sure that no one is inside. Mark gonna come through inside of pantry. He finds one, but Smoke's not gonna be aware. Gonna catch a couple bullets in the back, but gonna try and play out his life as Leon's gonna continue his reign for Team One. Lucid recognized out in bathroom. I don't believe Leon remembered that he had the hatch open, so he's going to walk by that as Lucid was prepared for it. Impact chosen. He's actually going to get caught out with that lifeline as his hand. Bonker's going to hop down from the top of square, and that's something about Coastline that is not talked about too often. You can rotate to anywhere in this map in just about 8 seconds. It's very, very fast-paced because of that massive square in the center of the map.
So Down into another advantage situation for Secret here. And again, it's on that defensive side where they've been able to close out so convincingly. The real test is going to come after this round when they switch sides. We'll talk more about that in a moment here. Fonker is able to knock out yet another player. It's down to only one. Falls again, having to pull it off. The player we haven't seen too much of so far from this event. Generally the support player more than anything here for Team One, but it's also going to be trying to pull off a clutch now in this 1v3 situation. Already started off in a 1v4, finds the feed again, knocks down that first player, tries to read into the roti just a tad too early though, and as a result of that goes down to the Legion. And we'll see Team Secret this time confirm the 4-2 at half, right as we're about to switch sides.
Team Secret's info game is on Mach 9 right now. I mean, these guys are insane with it here on Coastline. You guys can see anything all the way down to Lucan trying to take over bathroom. They establish angles above. Not only that, I mean, the only thing I would say that they kind of messed up is that they didn't recognize early enough that he was in there. Smoke almost died for that, but eventually Smoke would end up going down. Anyways, really didn't matter at the end, but always something that Team Secret can work on.
Yeah, definitely stuff they can work on, especially with the lead they have now. But the time for them is going to be to focus on their attacking side. This is where things started to go a little bit wrong for them. This is where they started to make quite a few mistakes back on Villa. And we never really saw it get corrected, although they were still able to hold their own and bounce back in the second half. They won't have that luxury if they fall behind early this time. It's the lead that they will lose and ultimately fall on the map to Team One if they don't quickly find a way to correct those issues from map number one and close out. Thankfully, the other good side of the coin for them here is going to be the fact that it's just three rounds required for Team Secret to get the close out on this map and the series on top of that to push them into the semis.
Just to put a cap on that first half of Coastline, Hookah was played three times, but not a single time did we see that exact take from yesterday where they would bring the Habana, push her up luggage, and then get the couch wall open. And Team Secret wasn't countering that. There was no bandit. There was nothing to try and deny that wall. So with none of that up, I'm very surprised that Team One didn't go back into that same fashion of, okay, let's bring Habana, let's open up couch, let's make it where Smoke can't really hold down billiards, and then we'll go for plant. Team Secret more or less just running over all of Team One's plants.
Especially with how successful it was, too, when you consider just how much it, you know, allowed them to get easy access to billiards for like at least two or three rounds before it finally was corrected by bringing a bandit into the play.
Well, I will say this, though. Team Secret's had international play before. The 92 Dream Team guys definitely have not. So it's more or less adapt or die, and 92 Dream Team definitely died. So,
unfortunately. Died to live another day, though, as I'm sure we'll be seeing them in the future at yet another event. And we'll be seeing them at Pro League at a minimum.
Yeah, tip of the cap to the boys, 92 Dream Team for that especially. And they definitely made for a hell of a match yesterday. Even though the scoreline was pretty far off, you know, 7-3, but still, a lot of fun to watch. Skadina, though, will start things off onto Feral. So, seems that it is going to be Team One's time, but no, Leon. Maybe he's already getting the diffuser down. Is this Team One? Is this Team Secret? Who is this? We saw this earlier from Team One, but it seems like Team Secret's going to adapt the exact same thing as what they did onto Villa with an extremely rushed plant, and it's going to work out for them. Team Secret already has their angles established. Lucid trying to mess with their plans, though, as the limbs will go downstairs inside of Blue.
Incredibly split up push ultimately. Falls picking up another one, so it's all on Funkers. Funkers, though, doesn't catch the run out from Lucid down below, and as a result of that, he'll get the guaranteed close out on the 3v1, and off of that, Team One will still be able to control the opening ground despite the fast-paced play that we see on the opener here from Secret.
Both of these teams trying the exact same thing against each other is actually quite comical because it literally went the same way, just on different sides. You know, they try to quick plant Hookah, they get the diffuser down, but they get eaten alive. Team One tries to quick plant inside of delivery for Kitchen, gets eaten alive. It looks like these teams both understand one thing about each other. Aggression.
And they unfortunately haven't figured out how to make that aggression work into a plant just yet, or at least how to solidify it in the post plant. They can get the plant onto the ground. It's after that where things get a little bit messy, and you could see hints of that right from the start of the plant with how split up Team Secret was. To be fair, they were trying to counter out some of the roaming presence that was still alive on the map due to how early on we saw Team Secret attempting this, but still far too many players falling off the site as a result of that, along with the fact that no utility had been baited out. You can see all three of the smoke grenades being tossed back in to try and force players outside of the site, or at a minimum into an awkward position where they could also be knocked out by members of Team One who were still holding with pretty much full control over by billiards. That's as such why we were able to see Team One come out on top with the defuse there. And now we're gonna move downstairs over to the bars instead of shifting over towards Kitchen, where we've seen a lot of other teams choose as their second site.
All right, well, once again, Team Secret on defense. I'm very interested to see what Team Secret's Team 1 on defense. I'm very interested to see what Team Secret's idea is for the offense on this site. Traditionally speaking, you're going to want to take over Hookah and most of the upstairs. Try and play those vertical angles. This is exactly why they have Bonkers on that buck. Able to eliminate most of the top floor, and they even have some more soft destruction by a couple of other members of Team Secret. Bloom's going to be donning the Dokubi, which we haven't seen too often this tournament, but she helps out quite a bit, especially when a heavy roam game is going on. Making that phone vibrate in people's pockets is a big deal. T1 already ready for this aggression, as Leon is going to force his way into offices as Prize lies in wait for the man to try and challenge his door.
Still going to be Ryan that strikes first here for Team Secret, though, taking out Leon at the beginning of the match. Again, that's another member of Team Secret getting caught early on. Same issue that we were seeing back in the previous round that we started out this half on. Reduct also going to be working with Scadini here. The small pinhole angle to try to catch anyone that attempts to push back in from service, while Lucid and Ryze also have a crossfire to work together. Great distraction with the drone, though. I don't even know if it was intentional or not. Probably not. But Feral is able to utilize it regardless to find Lucid. Reduct from the inside. Oh, over on the bathroom end of things. He's going to be able to take out Falkers, and this is a difficult push for the Nomad to make now. She has to deal with players on either side. The phone call has come in the meanwhile from the Dokubi. Some of the Team 1 players hopefully exposed, but it seems they've dealt with shutting off those phones very quickly, and Team Secret just hasn't been able to capitalize on it in order to leverage a kill.
Team 1 making it difficult every step of the way here for Team Secret to gain any map control, and that's really the tale of the tape, at least for this round. Finally, Dokubi will fall. No more logic bombs in her, and neither will there be life, but Feral will get the refrag, and mostly equal things out, as you will only have three members left for Team 1. Team Secret sent it too, so this is definitely doable. But Team 1 is not afraid to still put roamers on deck. Don't have everybody rotate just yet. We can still see if Team Secret tries for a take over from the east side, and they could definitely punish that, as Capital is going to come in, but it's going to be Feral that strikes first here on the Nomad. Meepy going to be rotating in through offices. Feral was sitting down inside a blue bar. Yes, he was, until that man inside square. The Toxic Babe going to do quite a bit of damage with that smoke, as Feral's still very, very aware of this man. Going to try and rotate in through square, and he actually ends up losing that gunfight to the MPX. That gun at range is not the best, but this time it's going to work out. Meepy, though, will find falls in the process. Apera, such a good weapon. And Reduct gonna have to try and battle it with that MPX. Again, the damage margin and the damage drop-off on that SMG, not the best, but maybe more than likely just gonna try and play this close angle here on the couch. Redux waiting for the rotation. Maybe still has a tactical crossbow ammo as well, so he could shut down one of these rotations here from Reduct for an extended period of time. Seems like the challenge is gonna come through. Nitro Cell gonna fall out, not gonna do any damage to Meepy. Reduct gonna slowly work his way inside, but the sprint gonna bring the gun down to his belly. Doesn't have time to bring it back up. Meepy gonna capitalize on that, and it's another round here for Team Secret.
I think there was like a last-second crouch from Meepy too that also got him out of the crosshairs and made it a lot more difficult for the last player alive there. Team to connect the shots. Secret, get that response in. They're right back in control.
Again, I always love when it comes down to these very, very minor decisions. If Reduct doesn't sprint here, he has a very good chance on winning this gunfight. That angled grip, you see how quick that gun goes up, even though he did do the sprint animation. If he doesn't sprint there, very good chance that he wins that gunfight.
But doesn't end up happening this time, so it's Team Secret in control once again. Still working with their 4-2 lead they started this half off with. Granted, dropped the first round, but now they're back up with a two-round advantage of 5-3. Two more away from a series closeout. 2-0 overall, knocking Team 1 out of this tournament, the first of three Brazilian teams that's in this event.
And you got to be happy for LATAM about that. I mean, all three LATAM teams that showed up here all going to top 8. Fantastic for the region, definitely happy to have them here. I think that does, you know, kind of a disappointment was that we didn't have Arrow Wolf here today so we could have representation from every single region. But again, Arrow Wolf looked very, very good for their first little taste, as far as I know, of international play.
I mean, right from the bat, right? Nearly pulled off the upset against Dark Zero. So that alone is a story. Unfortunately, Dark Zero seemed to have a lot of struggles at this land, as far as we can tell. Didn't get to catch them on stream too much, besides a few highlights here and there. So we don't know exactly what transpired, but they ended up dropping out in the Swiss stage yesterday. And I think for a lot of people, one of the two favorites to win the event. Didn't end up happening, so we said an early goodbye to them. But it's left us with an incredibly enticing bracket overall throughout the rest of today. You definitely want to see all three of the matches, and of course the rest of this one as well.
while this is the traditional lineup here for Team One on defense, Lucid on the Doc, Reduct on the Valkyrie, Ryze on the Maestro, and Falls on the Smoke. But a little bit of a difference we have here is Skadina to be on the Legion instead of the Jaeger. Then find out that Team Secret definitely enjoys getting aggressive, and those goo mines, not only good for information, but also good for slowing down your opponent.
Still drone focus right now for Team Secret. They haven't really tried to do any big moves here just as of yet. We're back to Mars once again to play off of this time around. We are going to see, or actually I think we're Kitchen this time, excuse me. Going to see Elims and the rest of the team move in. They'll take quick upstairs control. Secret already working their way in. They pretty much got VIP under control here too, so that's already a good amount of real estate to work off of upstairs. They can certainly start to harass down into the kitchen now with this much control. Especially when you consider they have Buck in play, although Funkers himself has taken a good amount of damage, so it's probably going to be more Leon right now to try to make these peaks. He actually just looked right out of play. I'm not sure if there was a wall in between. Something else blocked. It looks like the vision is slightly obscured still, so we can't catch Ryze just yet. Ryze tries to take the fight against Leon, though, and pays the price for it. A Secret gets a start at 5v4. First floor.
Team Secret, with those early drones upstairs, are going to recognize out that Team One doesn't have a single soul upstairs. So they're going to take full control as Feral continues to tack on. Finally going to get shut down by Reduct, but it doesn't appear that it's going to matter. It's all on Reduct and Lucid. As Mabee's put the bomb down, Lucid will find the kill from upstairs. Pre-fire almost falls through as it was Leon rotating inside of the double bar area. Mabee's actually going to reset the plant. Leon will find yet another kill as all left up to Lucid with this dock. He was a top breaker yesterday, finding 12 kills against 92 Dream Team on the same map. They are 3 for 3 on plants right now from Team Secret. Plenty of time to establish these angles. This is not a good place for Lucid.
Lucid left alone once again, trying to have to go for this clutch. We've got Leon rotating back upstairs. He's got Vision on the diffuser. Oh, Lucid though gets the better of Leon upstairs regardless of that. Great response to start things off, but he's got two more players to find, and already half the time when the diffuser is gone. Both of these players are going to be outside. He's walking right into a trap, doesn't even realize it. Still gets the first of those two kills. A nice attempt from Lucid, just far too much to battle off against. And now Team Secret are one round away from closing out the series.
They are 3 for 3 on plants on offense right now. That's insanity, especially with how aggressive we saw Team One yesterday on Coastline on their defensive rounds. Right now, they're really falling apart. Their roam game just is not there. They were more or less going for a horizontal setup, and it just didn't work out for them. Team One immediately recognizing out, hey, they haven't had a single person rotate upstairs, so let's just push all five upstairs, gain full control of that, make it where they can't rotate at all, set up air jabs, and then just make it to where we can plant for free. Get a couple of picks on site, have Feral just walk in there and make everything is just massacre fest as he picks up two, and then at the end of the day, Team Secret ahead, 6-3.
And again, Team Secret looking to solidify a bit of a new legacy here for themselves after dropping out of Pro League recently. Still trying to prove to their fans that they are a team worthy of being watched here. And so far, they're doing exactly that with their performance at this LAN. Coming out of absolutely nowhere. Coming out with, you know, no one expected, I think, this type of performance from them as they've been able to push their way all the way through into the quarterfinals with a 3-0 record as well. Perfect record coming out of the Swiss stage. And now about the 2-0 Team One.
I can tell you one thing. As a long-standing IDK fan, I'm very happy to see these boys back in form. It's something special when you see that amount of coordination on a team, and it just makes me happy, man. It's always a cool thing to see Rainbow played in such a fantastic fashion.
Well, we'll get to see it played at least one more time here in just a moment. In case you guys didn't realize that we do have a pause call. I think it was by Team Secret, if I was hearing the team comms correctly. So they're just taking a second to themselves before they head back in. And then we'll play what very well could be the final round, but mind you, guys from Team One are not out of this just yet either. This is their own map pick, and they seemed relatively confident on it with their play that they had just yesterday against on stream game of 92 Dream Team, along with the two other games we saw them play against both Dark, Zero, and DG, where they also found success. 3 for 3 at this LAN so far on this map. This would be the first loss, and unfortunately, also the loss that would send them home. They need to rebound and pick up the next three rounds consecutively.
For those Brazilian fans at home, if you want to see Team One try and battle back, at least on this round, you're going to want some roam presence upstairs. It has to happen. If they don't have it, Team Secret's just going to do the exact same thing. They're going to recognize out that no one's playing upstairs very early on. They've been setting up drones around staircases, which is a traditional thing you do in quite a few maps, just to check for rotate. If somebody's rotated upstairs and they don't come back down, obviously they either drop the hatch or they're going to stay upstairs. But But that last round, Team One not having a single soul upstairs, Team Secret just gets it for free, able to establish as many angles as possible. They even brought more hard destruction. Last time they had the buck, but Fonka's gonna be on the sledge this time, which he can actually cause even more destruction. The only difference is Buck can do it from underneath. He can only do it from above. So on this site, sledge definitely gonna be the operator choice that you want, especially with no nitro cells on the field.
Team Secret again looking to try and make some movement to the inside. Redux got actually a very good position. It's likely a catch to do, but no. Feral already moving in again. This incredibly aggressive play from Feral moves in to take out Ryze. Falls after that as well. Meepy already in the inside of service entry. The play upstairs from the dock is not going to be able to stop this plant from happening anymore. It's going down 5v3 within the first minute or so of the round here. Great stuff from Secret and also not a huge amount of damage. Elims with yet another pickup against Skadina. The players from Team One are falling time after time again. They're getting chip damage. You can see four players from Secret are incredibly low, nearly one-shottable, in fact. But it's all down to both Lucan and Ryze right now to try and bring this back. And unfortunately, Reduck that it is, excuse me, to try and bring this back. And it's just not really going to be possible. Reduck is stuck between a rock and a hard place. He goes down, and it's Team Secret to pull up the 2-0, pushing them into the semifinals. Our first team to accomplish this today.
Well, Team Secret looking even more adaptable today, I would say. Against NiP, they really couldn't find their footing, but here against Team One, another Brazilian squad, they're able to take it all the way, and they're going to Championship Sunday. So we'll see exactly what's going to happen with that, but just to break a little bit of thing down for you here, four plants, four rounds. That offensive set from Team Secret, deadly.
It's great stuff. We'll be able to talk about it a little bit more later, but for now, it's back to our desk with Ray and Veli, who are going to break down this matchup and the highlights from it.
Awesome, man.
That was dominant performance.
Thank you, Blue. Thank you, Stokes. Incredible stuff. That was fantastic.